Hi there.
Who is?
I'm Gretchen McFly. I'm your host today on this Devstream number 88. And with me today is...
Reto-Moto.
Welcome. We have a lot of stuff to go through today. But we'll, as always, start with the news. Then we'll have a look at the 105 update called Medic. And we'll also have a look at the 104 update, currently named Engine Room.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And at some point we'll have a giveaway.
Oof. Ooh, nice.
That's very nice.
Free stuff.
Cool. Free stuff is always nice. So, we have the news. First off, we have the Winter 4 release.
Yeah.
New planes. New controls.
Yeah. That was awesome.
Seems like people are having a lot of fun.
Yeah. Even Reto Hell 9K can fly the planes now. So
that's very good.
Yeah.
Even I can fly the planes.
Wow, impressive.
I can't fly anything. So we're having fun and you're having fun.
Hopefully.
Well, it seems that the air combat has definitely increased.
Yeah, it's given them a lot more like just the appearance of different planes in the air. It's really cool. It's tremendous.
And we really enjoyed the many YouTube videos we've seen of people doing cool stuff.
Yeah.
So thank you for that. And speaking of YouTube, we of course have the obvious challenge. We just finished one, and the winners are online at our website.
Mm-hmm.
We might even have the link available. There we are. And we of course have a new obvious challenge called, as you might see, it's called a submachine gun. And well, it's a great surprise, it's about submachine guns. We want you to do, as usually, we want to do an epic video, a fun video, and a fail video. All the details of how you submit these weird videos to the challenge, the prizes and stuff, they're on the webpage, they're on the forums, as well as the three current winners. There's some very, very good videos this time. So we're grateful. And speaking of, well, new stuff, we have an update coming.
Yeah.
That might go into one of the actual updates, or might go in as a hotfix.
I think it's gonna be a hotfix.
Yeah.
That's gonna be released really soon.
You're taking a poke at the
We're
the
taking a poke at the strategy game. Basically, we've kind of looked at how the morale system works and how we think it should work, and we've tried to think of what makes sense in how, like, what the morale really expresses, and then we've made some hotfixes. So the first thing is that when you get attacked as a defender with low morale, you now get undeployed and lose all your resources. So that's before they would only be lost if you attacked with a low morale assault team, but now you actually lose it. And it means that, well, what we want the morale expression the morale system to express is that your troops are low on morale. If they encounter something that's difficult to overcome, they just they dissolve, they disappear, they get killed, they flee. So that's what we're trying to express with this. Once we've done this, we thought, well, does it make sense that when you lose all your resources that you're low on morale and have to rebuild your assault team? And it really doesn't.
Yeah.
So we decided to remove the rebuilding phase of the assault team when you get knocked out of combat, which means that you can apply for new resources and then you can enter the queue and wait for your resources straight away after being undeployed. Another thing we did was that we've noticed that some people have been abusing the undeploy or withdraw button a bit to teleport assault teams around the map. So what we've changed is that once you undeploy an assault team, you basically forfeit your resources and then hand them over to your faction again, to the stockpile. which means that if there are any leftover resources, you basically lose some. Give them to the faction, but you don't get a refund. And it makes more sense. We'll try to keep a notice on what people think on the forums and if this is a change that we're happy with. But right now, I think it's a system that makes sense.
That's great.
Yeah,
that's great. And in other news, we wanted to point your attention towards another blog post we had recently. Let's show it if we can. That's the second. Yeah, because our good friend Ansi made the small Stuart saves the day, and it's really, really cute, and it's really well done. And if you haven't had time to read it yet, then stop by the website and do so.
Yeah.
It's very nice. Much appreciated.
Small commercial break.
And we've been told we need to take a small break due to technical difficulties.
Likes.
So please hang in there. And we're back. Hi again.
Hi.
Sorry, we're having a bit of problems, technical problems, as you might have noticed. Basically, the streaming software wanted to be updated about 5 minutes before we went live. So spending, as one of you wrote, 5 weeks preparing this dev stream doesn't help us much if the software decides to do something in the last moment.
Well.
We are hoping that the sound works.
Yeah.
Kind
I hope if you didn't get the last part, I think you can just try to watch the stream again and just turn it up.
Yeah. Hopefully. We're not going to run you through all the news again. But we're sorry for the difficulties.
Yeah.
And we are moving on. Yeah. Let's move on.
Right.
As you might have seen, we have made a collaboration with Lionsgate, the fine people at Lionsgate. Let's have a look at it. Yeah, they have a fine movie called Hacksaw Ridge that you might have seen. We thought it was a pretty cool movie, especially having the notion that one man can do or can make a difference in the war.
Mm-hmm.
Something that we feel is very close to our game.
Yeah.
So
and it's a World War II themed.
Yeah.
We always like that.
Yeah. kind of works well.
Yeah.
So we reached out to them and we put together what we're calling a medic bundle. That contains a digital copy of the movie, it contains 14 days of veteran membership, and it contains our new medic kits and medic boosters. We should make sure to say that this bundle is only available on Steam, and it's only available for US customers. That has to do with the distribution rights for the movie. course, we wanted it to be available to everyone in the world.
Mm-hmm.
But, well, things are as they are. So the medic bundle is only available to US customers. However, the medkit and the medic booster pre-order DLC is available to everyone. So you can find that on our Steam store page.
Yeah.
That means that we actually have some new content coming in the game.
Yay!
Medkits. Something that you, the community, have asked for quite a while.
Yeah.
And that we have wanted to do for almost as long.
Yeah, we just we had to find the right way of doing it, I guess.
Exactly. And, we can't show you the in-game version yet.
No, it's still in an early stage. Needs some animations done, but the core functionality is done, and we can walk you through what's how it works.
Yeah,
yeah.
But you know, tell me, when doing a medic or a med kit, it has to be fun in-game.
Yeah,
and I'm guessing a lot of time went into actually figuring out how to make it fun.
Yeah, there are some approaches done by other games, and it's always outweighing how much they actually how unbalanced they get if you do them if you give them too much power. So we had to land on a design where they make a difference, but they're not overpowered. And I think we did some nice choices there. It's not a revive kit. You can't revive dead people, but you can give health to wounded comrades or teammates.
Exactly, yeah. So that's also the question of when you're wounded in combat. I mean, we do strive to keep authenticity in our game, but we also want to make it fun.
Yeah,
and it's kind of no fun if you get shot in the leg and can't move
anywhere and can't walk. No. So you can be low on health and still perform as well as a soldier with full health. Of course, you're more subject to rifle shots in the foot, but that's how it is.
That's how it is. Yeah. But let's have a look at the. We actually do have renders.
Yeah.
Of the new medkits.
This is the first one. This is the U.S. Army.
U.S. Army. Yeah.
First aid dressing. And this is a box containing one, I think.
One field dressing.
One field dressing.
And they're of course available for all factions.
This is the German version. And this is the Soviet version.
Of course, the renders doesn't really say how big they are. So we got Cristiano.
Yeah, Cristiano. Who has an endless supply of military equipment. And these are actually Danish, I think. The writing is in Danish. So this is a field dressing. It has what's it called?
A bandage. I think we can
Can you open it up? Or
allowed to.
We're allowed to?
Yeah.
Cool.
I think so. Yeah.
Let's do it. Then we can maybe show you how it's going to work in game.
See, I'm probably never. This is going to be the most not fun. Tail on the red line. There we are. Ah, it's
okay.
Not that difficult.
Nice. So I'm wounded in combat. I got hit.
So we need to do something about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I wasn't allowed to actually wound you.
No, we decided it would be better for the stream if I was in able condition.
So you would do in combat, I guess.
Yeah.
We'd simply
great.
Dress you up. So
cool.
We kind of dress you up.
Do you actually know how to use this?
Because I have no idea.
There's also this stuff. I think you apply this afterwards.
Probably.
Yeah.
I mean, if you were actually wounded, you would lose your arm in a bit.
Yeah.
Hey, you don't need it anyway.
There's a slight difference of this reenactment and how it's gonna work in game.
So it's not gonna be like this.
It's not exactly like this. It's gonna.
It seems very streamlined to me, though.
Yeah, it's gonna be a bit faster. Great. But you can heal teammates. That's the important part. So and now I'm on full health again.
What's the health bar?
Yeah.
Full health bar.
You can imagine me being on full health. a medkit is gonna, or a field dressing is gonna heal up to. I think we're right now we're at 80% health. Well, you heal 80 yeah. points. So if you're down 20, then you heal up to max. Maybe that's gonna change. I think we probably gonna stick on that. Maybe 100 health. We haven't decided yet.
That's a balancing issue.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there's two types of medkits coming.
Yeah. There's there's two types. There's the what's it called?
That's the I think that's the first aid
yeah,
kit.
Yeah, the first aid kit. It contains one field dressing, and it takes one equipment point.
Yeah.
So it's one field dressing that you bring with you that you can use on yourself or on a teammate. And then there's the medic pouch.
Medic pouch, yeah.
That has it contains three of those of the field dressings. So it has three uses. So you can heal yourself or a teammate three times. And obviously you can restock, and we've made a bit of a change on that. Okay. Instead of placing the medic kits in the ammo crates, which doesn't really make sense, you resupply in the health crates. And you can obviously only resupply if you have one equipped. And the medic crates still work as they do. You can still heal from medic crates. Yeah.
That's pretty cool, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And one thing we've decided to do is that if you carry one or more of these field dressings with you, you can actually see your teammates' health if they're in close proximity to you, which means that you're able to spot a wounded teammate and run to him and give your teammate your field dressing.
That's cool. That's
yeah.
Cool. Yeah. And how fast do they work?
Right now they are at 3 seconds. It takes 3 full seconds for you to heal yourself or a teammate. The mechanic is that if you go up to a teammate and then we play an animation where you like hand over the dressing, and then it takes 3 seconds for you to heal your teammate.
Okay.
If you use it on yourself, you can just use it in a corner somewhere, and it will take 3 seconds as well. Yeah.
That's great.
Right now it's 3 seconds. It might change.
That's great. Great.
Yeah.
And there's a ribbon that yeah. goes with it?
Yeah. We created a medic ribbon that has three combat badges on it. There's one combat badge for healing faster. There's a combat badge for additional range.
Yeah.
And then there's a combat badge to carry one extra field dressing, or two or three, depending on the combat badge. We actually have some nice pictures of the renders of the combat badges.
Gotten by Reto-Moto.
Yeah.
Today, actually, so they're very new.
This is the combat badge for faster healing. This one is for.
That's one for carrying an extra field dressing.
Yeah, that's right. And the last one is for the additional range you get.
Yeah, stress that with additional range, we don't mean that you can heal somebody in the other side of the room. It's not magic healing.
No,
it's it more gets, by it making gets, yeah. it easier to heal people.
Yeah, yeah, more effective. So you don't need to get as close.
Yeah. Exactly. And these are coming in the March update.
Yeah,
that we have targeted for the 21st of March. And if you bought the pre-order package, the way it's going to work is that when the update is released, you'll get a pop-up in the game prompting you to choose which of your soldiers you want the medkit to appear on.
Yeah.
So that's quite easy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're very much looking forward to seeing how they will work in the game.
Yeah.
And how
I think support roles are always fun in our game. The wrench is really cool if you're that kind of guy that wants to help out teammates. And this is definitely going to change the game. Yeah. I'm looking forward to healing and being healed on the field. Yeah.
Great. That's 105. And some of you might think, well, you're missing a number there. And
yeah.
We are. The 104.
The 104 update.
Actually
yeah.
coming before
yeah.
the 105.
Yeah.
So just to jumble it about a bit,
yeah.
we're going to talk about the 104, which is called Engine Room.
Mm-hmm.
And, well,
There's a reason behind that.
With the render.
Yeah. We're doing an engine upgrade, as you can call it. It's as you've probably noticed, we've run some render tests on a prototype, and we feel that the render is in a state right now where we don't have any known issues. So we're releasing it, and we, as some of you might have remembered, we've tried to. We've tried doing this before, but this time around we're going to do it a bit differently. First of all, it still ships with the DirectX 12 render in it, but it's disabled by default, and you can only enable it as an experimental feature. Yeah. Yeah. So you have to actively enable it, and it's not done. It's not tested completely. So we're going to focus on what the new render without the DX12 feature set includes, because that's an upgrade in of itself, as you have probably noticed on prototype.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Speaking of prototype,
You
should take a drive.
I should take a drive.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I'm going to take a drive around prototype.
Yeah.
And I'll talk about the render and what it can do, and what you have done to it.
As the first thing you're probably going to notice is that there's going to be a small change of, well, not maybe not a small, but a change of how the game looks. We've changed the way that we do tone mapping from the way that we do it, as you know it in the game right now, which is like, I think it's a linear tone mapping. And tone mapping is when you try to convert an HDR image to a low dynamic range image. So basically you have to map the colors around the screen, because screens can only show low dynamic range. So what that is going to do, we change it to a more filmic tone mapping, which means that the contrast is higher.
Yeah.
It's going to look more crisp, not as gray as you're used to. So that makes a huge difference. But when we did this, we realized that the current weather settings couldn't exactly handle how the new game looks. It's always an artist's decision on how the weather settings look. So we tweaked all the weather settings as well. We're just gonna choose let's go into the beautiful French countryside and take a look at the render.
Let's do that, yeah.
So, all the weather settings have had an upgrade. Yeah. The night setting is a beautiful full moon night setting. The dawn and dusk weather settings are really beautiful with the sun glaring through the trees. It's really pretty. So that's one of the things we've done. And we've added some new features.
Yeah.
We've added the tone mapping, and the we've added temporal anti-aliasing as well, which is TAA for those of you who know the term. It's a different way of doing AA, where instead of looking at the static image, we look at a range of like the history of the frames. So it gives more it's in some conditions it's much better than FXAA, which is the current anti-aliasing feature we have in. In some other instances, it gives it's a bit more. What's it called? It's moving a bit,
okay.
But overall, I think you can choose between which ones you want to use. But overall, I think the TA is much better. So that's the one I prefer at least. So I'm gonna enable it now. And also, we've added the option to choose your render resolution, a difference from the actual resolution, which is the actual resolution is what the screen is showing. So the UI is rendered in the native resolution here, but I can turn down the render resolution to a lower resolution set if I want to, if my graphics card can't perform well enough. So that's a new cool feature I think some people are gonna enjoy, especially. if you have a low-end spec PC.
Basically, we want people to play around with it a bit to find the option that fits their computer or their taste, for that matter.
Exactly. So let's just spawn down here. Whoop. And take a beautiful look at the how the terrain looks. I'm going to switch to a... I can't remember which one it is. Not that one. Oh, too dark. This is the night I talked about. As you can see, the horizon has a beautiful glare, and the moon is just big and round, and we have some nice stars that even twinkle a bit. So this is I really like this weather setting. I know a lot of you don't really like the night setting as we have it right now, but this one is it's definitely gonna change how it feels. Let's see if I can find I think this is the morning preset.
Oh, yeah.
Where you can see the sun is low in the sky, or the evening, can't remember. But yeah, as you can see, the contrast is much higher. I'm going to spawn a vehicle. You can take a look at the... It's really pretty. I could fly around in free cam like forever and just look at the highlights and how the game just shines with this new preset. Obviously, this is just the beginning of the render track. Well, not the beginning, but a rework. There are some optimizations in here as well. A lot of you will notice frame rate increase, so it's a completely overhauled render that we have here.
We got some very nice feedback from you guys that when you took part in the prototype test. We've run about 3-4 render tests, something like that. We got a lot of nice feedback.
Yeah,
And it's much appreciated that you took part in it.
Yeah,
actually our QA guys made some statistics.
Mm-hmm.
That showed that about 70% of people who took part in the latest test experienced a better or much better performance.
Yeah.
And when we measure the frames per second, it rounds out about 20%
increase
in performance.
Yeah.
So we're pretty happy about that.
Yeah. For a lot of people, it's just those... The small amount of frames that you need to get to those magic 60 frames per second.
Exactly.
So that's just it's really gonna help a lot of you. We hope. And as I said, this is just the beginning of the new render track. We have when doing this reworking, we obviously had in mind that that this was something that we could expand on, and it makes it easier for us to add some cool new features. We have a lot of stuff in mind, and a lot of stuff that's in the works right now. Something could be like adapting to a physically based rendering setup, which would help us when we create assets. And so there's a lot of possibilities, and we'll just look into this and choose the ones that we want to go with, and just keep on improving. It's going to be great, and we especially look forward to just getting feedback seeing how it performs. So it's going to be great.
But yeah, a lot of the new render a lot of it is to again make the picture nicer and make the optimization better.
Yeah.
But and just an important part of it is to actually open up the render for us to work with.
Definitely.
In the years ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a beginning of the render track, and we had some time to spend on it while trying to figure out and close all the bugs on it, and we're really looking forward to releasing this. This is going to be a huge update.
And we haven't set a date for when the update is out yet.
No, but it's coming soon.
Very soon.
Very soon. I can promise that.
Yeah.
So,
exactly. That's great.
Great.
Should take a quick spin around.
Sure. Let's do it. Oh, well, I can do it. I can do it. It's easy. Lots of room, I think. There you go.
There we go, yeah.
The beautiful French landscape. I'll try to switch off the TAA and see if... I'm not sure you can notice on this stream. It's something that you can see definitely if you're... when you're running it on your own setup. And I can try to switch down the render resolution. Now maybe you can see the pixelation, and if I turn up the antialiasing, then you should be able to see how it... It bursts the image a bit, and that's the thing you get when you run AA in general. There's no way around that unless you run like super sampling, but that's really expensive. So this is a good approach to giving a smooth image. Where actually this is playable on the lowest render resolution and it will run pretty well on a low end PC. Yeah. So yeah, it's really great, and it doesn't have the giant UI that you usually get when you just change the resolution. So this is going to be a huge benefit for a lot of our players.
Cool. Great. Looking forward to that.
So I'll fly off in the sunset.
You did that? Because we did promise you, even if our mics didn't work properly at the moment, but we did promise you a giveaway.
Yeah.
And we're going to do a giveaway.
Let's do it.
Yeah. And, you kind of know the drill and then you don't. We need to start up the software first.
Mm-hmm.
We have that available here. And what we need you to write today to take part in the giveaway is !medic.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start the giveaway.
Let's go ahead.
We'll go ahead.
And get started.
Just to make it clear, everybody writing !gold is not taking part in the giveaway, but everybody writing !medic is taking part.
Yes.
And...
have you mentioned what the giveaway is?
The giveaway is, oh, I forget.
1,000 gold.
1,000 gold, yeah. Yes, that's correct. And we should mention that if you're watching this on Facebook, you're not watching this on Facebook because we have technical difficulties. So everybody can take part in this giveaway.
Yeah, so if you're watching this on Facebook, you're doing something wrong.
Yeah, actually, I think we'd like to know what you're doing to watch this on Facebook then.
Cool.
That's cool. And we seem to have getting a lot of interest. That's cool.
Yeah. How long do you usually run this for?
Oh, until I'm kind of satisfied with enough users.
Yeah. People are still pouring in or what?
Yeah, they're still pouring in. That's impressive. Very cool. Lots. Pouring in, that's cool. And I think we're about there. So we're gonna stop the interest.
I'm gonna stop, and I'm gonna pick a winner.
Yeah, you're gonna pick a winner.
And the lucky winner is Not Final Form. I wonder what his final form is.
Yeah, we'd like to know that as well. Please type something in chat. And
I won. Yes, you did.
Yeah, you did.
And he...
you'll get picked up by Reto-Robotron.
Yeah.
Make sure you get...
Heroes and Generals will write to you.
Yeah.
Cool.
Exactly. Thank you for taking part.
Yeah.
We have a little bit left, not to show you, but to talk about.
Yeah.
Because part of the 104 engine room update is updating the cheat.
Yeah, the anti-cheat
engine. Anti-cheat system. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And to be brutally honest, are we going to talk anything about how that works from a technical point of view?
No.
No.
No. It's always going to be an arms race with the cheat developers. So we rather keep our cards close because they can't. We too have access to their cheats, and we're analyzing and inspecting every single one of them.
We've spent quite a lot of time doing that.
Yeah, we've updated the anti-cheat engine, so it can better detect cheats from now on, that along with our flagging system in the game makes us able to find cheaters. Hopefully better, most certainly better than we did before. Yeah. It wasn't too shabby before, but it's gonna be greater.
Yeah. It's continuously improving.
Exactly.
You might want to mention though that, I mean, if I were a cheater and I was thinking, oh, they updated the cheat system, I'm gonna stop using this cheat because it hasn't been discovered yet.
Yeah.
That kind of not helps you in any way.
If you use a cheat and we have information about cheat software running on systems, and even though we can actually retroactively detect cheats, we have information about that. So don't even think about using cheats, because you will end up in trouble if we catch you. Even though we only detected it after you used it. The thing is. The difference between our cheat engine and how the game is running is that we don't actually just upgrade the cheat engine when we upgrade the game. The cheat engine can be upgraded from day to day, from hour to hour, and we continually do this. So we're quite confident that this new system is gonna catch a lot of the stuff that we couldn't catch before. Not that there's really many cheaters in our game, but the ones that that do cheat, we'd like to swiftly be sure that they don't participate in the games that our beloved players play in, because it's an annoyance.
Simply, just to sound really whiny for a second.
Yeah,
it's simply. It's annoying that we need to spend time catching cheaters when that time could be spent doing the game.
Yeah, yeah. That's something we have to deal with. Yeah. But we're doing it. We're doing it, and we have the best people on it.
Yeah, we do. And we have to say that a lot of the help we get from new players when you use the in-game tool for reporting cheats or suspected cheats, that's very helpful. We get the ID, the mission ID, and the player names, and all the stuff we need, and then we investigate afterwards.
Yeah, yeah. The ones that we don't catch automatically through the cheat engine can be sifted through by the reporting system.
Exactly. So keep doing that.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
And that's about it for the 104 update.
Yeah, yeah. Looking forward to that. Yeah. It's gonna be awesome.
Exactly. And that's basically it for the dev stream today.
Yeah,
we talked about the news that might got sucked up in the microphone incident. We're sorry for that.
Yeah,
but there's an RBS challenge that you need to have a look at on the website. That's the most important part.
Yeah.
Then we talked about the medkits. We have the Hacksaw Ridge Heroes and Generals medic bundle available on Steam, US Steam, and. That ties into the 105 update medic coming March 21st, introducing medkits into the game.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about the 104 render engine, or engine room update, as it's going to be called, which is going to introduce a new render engine. Sorry, a new render engine and an updated anti-cheat system.
Yeah,
and that's about it. If you missed any of this dev stream, we're going to upload it on YouTube, where you can watch it. And we, of course, like you to follow us on Twitch. If I'm not mistaken, there should be a subscribe button somewhere above you.
In the meta space.
Exactly. Let's see, do we have anybody we're hosting afterwards? Reto Splixen might know this. Are we hosting anyone today? Maybe. So stick around and
find out.
Oh, cliffhanger. We don't know at the moment. And of course, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and most importantly on heroesandgenerals.com, where we post the blog posts that update you on what's happening with the game. And we'll be back in about 1 month, the 24th mm-hmm. of March, where we're going to show the new features in the 106 update.
Ooh.
So, yeah, that's it for today. We hope that you have a great weekend, and we hope to see you in-game, making a difference and fighting for your friends. Bye for now. Great weekend.